My Lord Constantine, we all know that Arthur chose you for king. But how can you expect your subjects to support you if you come not to their aid when they are in need?
While the cathedral here in Canterbury is the repository of many relics of power, I know not which of them could aid you against a giant. You must speak with Friar Albert in St. Albans. He knows more of such matters than any other in the church. He just left here to return to St. Albans.
So you fools have finally found my home. Welcome to your deaths.
Greetings to you, my lord. The stars portend your accession to the throne. In the future, I would advise you to consider well the Dark Realm. The ancient powers can greatly aid your cause, or bring it to ruin.
You prideful swine! You represent all that drove me away from the round table. See to your sword!
My friends, it is so good to see you. I feared I would perish before I was located. I am in your debt. Now we should quickly get word to my friends at Excalibur.
Please help us. We are desperate. Our elderly mother has been taken in the night. She is old and cannot long survive as a captive. We think she was taken towards the Forest Sauvage. Will you aid us? The giant at Camelot's gates has been enchanted by Morgan le Fay. He cannot be killed by mortal weapons, nor is Nineveh's magic powerful enough to defeat Morgan's spells. You must find a magical weapon, or one with divine power, to have any hope. You must seek advice from the clergy.
I have heard of the spell that encases its victim in crystal. It will require a powerful enchantment to break Merlin's bonds. I will need Hellsbane, Batwing, and the leg bone of a stag to make the Laxus spell work.
The evil magic of a mighty power is at work in the Forest Sauvage. I can feel it even here. But there is more. I cannot tell what it is, but an evil far greater than mortal man also stirs there. I fear for the realm.
Hail, travelers! Be wary should you journey northeast of London. A large force of Saxons gather in East Anglia. I know not what they intend, but surely it bodes ill.
I I did hear tale of barbarians gathering to the north. Who knows what those heathen want, but their force is said to be the largest ever seen here. If they mean harm to the realm, there are far too many for the king's forces. He will need allies.
Merlin? I may have heard of him. What would such knowledge be worth to you?
Hail, friend. You are welcome at our court, but I fear that we can provide no greater support at this time. We face grave dangers in our own realm and can spare no aid to Camelot. My lord, the Saxon Andolf has been killed. His troops have been routed. Thanks to your timely aid, we have prevailed. I swear my eternal fealty to you and the realm. As soon as we have repaired the damage here, I shall be at your command. I thank you for coming. My son has been kidnapped. If you can help find and recover him, I will pledge my fealty to Constantine and Britain. A peasant of the town says he saw a dark form in the night, heading out of the town towards the south.
Aha! Braggarts from the Court of Conceit! Such mighty wizards and warriors! I believe I shall have some sport and thrash you myself ere I have my troops clap you in irons.
Lord Constantine, we welcome you. We urge you, good sir, to always call on the Church in times of need. For godly counsel, power, and support, St. Albans, Almesbury, Canterbury, Glastonbury, or any of the other houses of the Lord stand ready to aid you in any way we can. I can tell you little of demon lore. Helier's book in our library contains spells relating to demons, but no follower of Christ may use these tools of darkness. It is said that there lives a scholar in Rochester with knowledge of these matters.
Lancelot has left Glastonbury. Bors may know where he is gone. Bors, however, is a suspicious man who has grown distrustful of the Round Table, particularly those he considers too prideful. Perhaps one who is not a knight could persuade him to assist.